Namaskar. My name is Paramli Rana and I'm a professional certified yoga teacher with Premanand Yoga. Today we are going to speak about Bhastrika Pranayama. Before we speak about Bhastrika Pranayama, let us understand what Pranayama is. Pran means swas and ayam means control. So Pranayama is also termed as controlled breathing exercise. Bhastrika means bhatti. So basically, as a lohar, you know, inhale and exhale, in a sense, as the air goes out and comes in, where in his workshop, similarly, Bhastrika Pranayama, we inhale and exhale with a force, which helps us cure many diseases in regards to our physical, mental health. Bhastrika Pranayama is one of the best pranayams, in which we have to sit either in the Padmasana, Arpadmasana, Sukhasana or Vajrasana. So our professional teacher, Shri Satish Ji, will show you how should we do the Bhastrika Pranayama. He is sitting in the Vajrasana and any person can practice it in either of the asanas. Once you sit in the Vajrasana, your spine should be straight. You should not bend over. Your spine should be straight and you should sit in the Dhyan Mudra. In order to sit in the Dhyan Mudra, you have to touch your first index finger with your thumb and all other three fingers should be straight, like this. Once we sit in the Dhyan Mudra, we will inhale as much as we can with a force and then we will hold for a few seconds, which is Kumbhak in yoga, and then exhale out. So Satish will demonstrate you how we should do the Bhastrika Pranayama. Inhale, which is also known as the Purak. Now we will hold for a few seconds, which is Kumbhak, and exhale, which is also known as Rechak in Yoga. Inhale, and exhale. One can practice Bhastrika Pranayama for 15 to 20 times once we start it. And as the days go by, as you practice it, you can increase the repetitions as per your capacity. By doing the Bhastrika Pranayama, one can get many and multiple benefits. The first and the main benefit is that you're getting more air and more oxygen in your body. Since lungs is the only organ in the body which supplies oxygen to different organs, like your organs in your stomach, your brain, and all other parts of the body. The oxygen and the air is supplied by the lungs. So once we do the Bhastrika Pranayama, we are getting more air, more oxygen in our lungs. Normally, this is scientifically proved that a person normally inhales approximately 1 to 1.5 liters of oxygen. But by practicing the pranayama and basically the Bhastrika Pranayama, we increase the capacity of the lungs to inhale more oxygen, which is approximately 2 to 2.5 liters. So the more oxygen and the more air goes in our body, it's better for whole body. All the dead cells can be regenerated by providing more oxygen. We have more oxygen in our blood by doing the Bhastrika Pranayama, and all ailments basically which are related to the respiratory system, like the asthma, bronchitis, can be cured by doing the regular practice of Bhastrika Pranayama. In this, we can also eliminate various blockages in our body, blockages that you have in our heart, blockages that is near the kidneys or any part of the body can also be reduced and completely cured by doing the Bhastrika Pranayama. We also get more oxygen supplied to the brain while we do the Bhastrika Pranayama. So the more oxygen goes in the brain, it is also helpful in curing many mental diseases like the depression, stress, and also insomnia, in which a person is not able to sleep properly. That person can also practice Bhastrika Pranayama continuously and they can have the magical benefits of this pranayama. There are few things that has to be taken care while we do the pranayama. Your body has to be straight, your eyes should be closed, and your complete concentration should be on your breathing. Because if you will not be concentrating on our breathing, your mind will not be focused. So once you concentrate on the breathing, your mind will be absolutely focused, your concentration would be correct, and you will have the many benefits of doing the Bhastrika Pranayama. Bhastrika Pranayama also help in, you know, providing a different benefits. If somebody is in, you know, want to use the spiritual life, if somebody tries to do meditation, they can also start doing the Bhastrika Pranayama. Because once you start doing the Bhastrika Pranayama, you either sit in the Padmasana, Sukhasana, or Padmasana, or the Vajrasana. So by sitting in this posture for, you know, high number of minutes, you develop the tendency and the capacity to sit in this position for longer hours. And in the ancient India, our yogis used to sit in this asana for many, many hours. And they used to also do the meditation for their spiritual benefits. Namaskar.